In this cosMik uCast quick tutorial, you'll learn how to record your voice with a reverb or any other effect the quick and easy way. To do that, you don't need anything additional, only the ESI USB microphone cosMik uCast and the included software. To record your voice with effects, like with a reverb or delay or something, you could use any of the supplied software that comes with a cosMik uCast. It works with Bitwig, Studio 8 Track, Wavelab LE, Cubasis LE. But the fastest way to do it is with the inTone 2 ESI edition, and therefore I chose this program for today's tutorial. So let's open inTone 2. The first thing we need to do is tell inTone which audio device we use. So we click on Options and choose Preferences. And here in the audio section, we choose the cosMik uCast and click OK. If the option cosMik uCast is not visible here, maybe it's because you haven't installed the driver yet. As a Windows user, you should definitely do that. In this case, download the driver on our homepage esi-audio.com and then go to Support and then to Download. Back to the actual topic. Our source is the microphone, so we choose that one up here. As you can see, you have several options, so you could also add a backing track or an instrument to your signal chain. That way you could perform a whole song and record it right away or just jam a little bit. So, quite a cool tool. As input, we choose channel 1 and 2, and then we can start to adjust the gain a bit so we're loud enough but avoid hard clippings. We can adjust the input gain right in the program and also on the front of our microphone. Once you're happy with your adjustments, you can move on to the effects. Simply click on the plus symbol and under VST2 you have many options to enrich, alter or improve the sound of your voice. So, for example, you could go for a noise gate to filter out background noise. But what we really wanted to add is a reverb and make it sound like in a large hall or church or something. So we add a second effect and choose reverb. Here we go. That's quite a difference already, but I think this sound is not reverby enough. So we can pimp that a bit using the effect editor by clicking on the little E right here. And here we simply move the mode controller to 4 or 5. Test. Now that already sounds better. Now before we hit the record button, let's first give the track a name and specify where on your hard disk the recording should be saved. This is done in the so-called track recorder, so in the master section we press that magical E again to open the track recorder. Here we click on Options and now we can rename the track and change the target folder. We could even go for another format, but I think WAV is the most reasonable choice. Confirm with OK. Now press the circles in the sections that you want to record. So you could record all the sections at once, but in our example we only need the first one here. And of course we press the circle under the master track where everything kind of runs together. Now all you have to do is click on the record button up here, and there you go. Once you're done recording, just click on this button again to stop. And here is the audio track. Green sleeves was my delight. Green sleeves was my... You can record your voice with effects, but you can also stream your altered voice live on the internet. And that's easy with Direct Wire by ESI. We've got a tutorial for that case too, so check it out here on YouTube.